Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are doing good at home. So we have started a new chapter, that is understanding quadrilateral. We have studied some of the properties. Let us first revise them, some of the important points from the chapter, and then we will start with exercise 3.1. So the important points are, the first one is, a polygon of n sides has n sides and vertices and n minus 3/2 diagonals. Okay, any polygon of n sides has n sides, n vertices, and n minus 3/2 diagonals. Okay, by this formula we can find out the given polygon has how many diagonals. Okay, the sum of the measures of three interior angles of the triangle is 180 degrees, that you know. Then polygon of n sides is divided into n minus 2 triangles. Okay, we have studied that in a quadrilateral, how many triangles we can form? 2 triangles. In pentagon, we have formed 3 triangles. In hexagon, how many triangles? We can make 4 triangles. So, how we can make n minus 2? Means, if we have taken hexagon, so n is 6. So, 6 minus 2 is 4. So, in hexagon polygon, we can get 4 triangles. So, by this formula n minus 2, we can know how many triangles we can form in a given polygon. The sum of the measures of all the interior angles of n-sided polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree. The sum of the measures of all the interior angles of the n-sided polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree. The sum of the measures of the exterior angles of any polygon is 360 degree. Interior angle is 180 degree, exterior angle is 360 degree. Okay. Now the measure of each angle of the polygon is 360 degree by n. Okay. 360 degree by n. Now if the sum of the measures of all the interior angles of n-sided polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree. So, these are some important points. Now, let's start the exercise 3.1. Now, in the first question of the exercise, what does the question says? Find the sum of the measures of the interior angles of the polygon, the five-sided. Okay. First, we have to find of five sides, pentagon. Okay. So, how we can find the sum of the measures? Measures of the interior angle of the polygon of five sides is equal to, just now we have studied that sum of the measure of the interiors of the polygon of n sides should be n minus 2 into 180 degree. Okay. So, we will put n is equal to 5 here. So, 5 minus 2 into 180 degree, and that is 3 into 180 degree, and that is 540 degree. Okay. So, n sides, if we are given a polygon of 5 sides, that is pentagon, then we will get the sum of the measures of interior angles as 540 degree. Now, another part of the question is, we have to find the measure of the interior angles, sum of the measures of the interior angles of 7 sides. Okay, 7 sides. If 7 sides is given, so n is equal to 7, we will put the value in the equation n minus 2 into 180 degree. So, 7 minus 2 into 180. So, 5 into 180 is equal to 900 degree. Okay. Now, in the same way, the third part of the question says about the 12-sided polygon. If 12-sided polygon is given, n is equal to 12. So, n minus 2 into 180 degree. So, 12 minus 2 is 10. 10 into 180 degree will give you 1800 degree. Okay, so for 5-sided polygon, sum of the measures of the interior angle will be 540 degree. For 7-sided polygon, n is equal to 7, and we will get 7 minus 2 into 180 degree, that will be 900 degree. And for 12-sided polygon, we will get 1800 degree. Hopefully you have understood. Let's move on to the next question. Now the next question says, what is the sum of the measures of the exterior angles of the regular hexagon? Okay, does each exterior angle measure 60 degree and why? And what does this question says that what will be the sum of the measures of the exterior angles of the regular hexagon? We all know that some of the measures of exterior angle is 60 degree and interior angle are equal. Okay? In regular polygon. Okay? Understood? In regular polygon, measures of the exterior angle and the measure of the interior angles are equal. Yes, each exterior angle will have measure 60 degree. Okay, 60 degree hoga na? So that the sum of the measures of the exterior angle of hexagon is equal to what? 60 degree into 60, which will be 360 degree. Okay, so one thing you have to always remember that in a regular polygon, measure of exterior angle and the measure of interior angle are equal. So yes, if the exterior angle is given 60 degree, then sum of the measures of all the angles of the exterior angles of the regular hexagon will be having 6 angles. So 60 degree into 6 will give you 360 degree. Now let's move on to the next question. Now in the third question, we are asked that how many diagonals does each of the following have? So first one is given a convex quadrilateral. Okay, convex quadrilateral mein. Now we all know one formula of finding out the diagonals is n into n minus 3 upon 2. Okay, so here in a convex quadrilateral, how we can find? Quadrilateral means 4 sides. So 4 into 4 minus 3 upon 2, which will be 4 into 1 upon 2 is equal to 2. So, a convex quadrilateral will have 2 diagonals, okay? Now, the second part of the question says, we have to find out of the triangle. Triangle will have how many diagonals? So, n into n minus 3 upon 2. So, it will be, n will be what? In triangle, it will be 3. So, 3 into 3 minus 3 upon 2, the answer will be 0. So, it will have 0 diagonals. Triangle will have 0 diagonals. Now, the third part of the question says, a regular heptagon. Heptagon means 7n. N is equal to 7. So, 7 into 7 minus 3 upon 2 is equal to 7 into 4 upon 2 is equal to 28 upon 2, and which is 14 diagonals. Okay, so a heptagon will have 14 diagonals. A convex quadrilateral will have 2 diagonals. Triangle will have no diagonals, and heptagon will have 14 diagonals. Next one. Now the next question asks that is the sum of the measures of the interior angles of 4-sided polygon shown in the figure 360 degree and why? So we are given a figure as this. Okay. So is the sum of the measures of the interior angles of 4-sided polygon shown in the figure is 360 degree? shown in the figure 360 degree and y. So here this is an example of concave quadrilateral. Okay. So concave quadrilateral will have is the sum of the measures of the interior angles of four-sided polygon shown in the figure is 360 degree? No, it is not, because it is a concave quadrilateral. Then the fifth one is it possible to have a polygon the sum of whose interior angle is 750 degree? Is it possible to have a polygon the sum of whose interior angle is 750 degree? No, because what is the answer for fifth? It is no, because the sum should be interior angles ka sum kitna hota hai? The sum should be equal to 360 degree. Okay, in a polygon. Now find the measure of the sides of a regular polygon whose each interior angle has a measure of 144 degree and 160 degree. So let's solve this one. So here we are given find the number of sides of the regular polygon, and we are given each interior angle has a measure of 144 degree. So in first case, given interior angle is 144 degree. Okay, so each exterior angle which we got 180 degree minus 144 degree, which will be what? 36 degree. Now therefore the exterior angle will be what? Exterior angle, the measure of each exterior angle will be, therefore the number of exterior angle will be 360 degree divided by 36 degree, which will be 10. So polygon will have how many sides? Ten sides. Okay, so it will be a decagon. Yes. Now the second part says about the measure of the interior angle is 160 degree. So given interior angle is equal to 160 degree. So the each exterior angle will be what? 180 degree minus 160 degree, that is 20 degree. Therefore, now total measure of the exterior angle is what? 360 degree, we have learned. Okay. So therefore, the number of exterior angles will be 360 degree by 20 degree, and which will be 18. Okay. Therefore, polygon will have 18 sides. Okay. Here the given interior angle was 144 degree. So each exterior angle is what? 180 degree minus 144 degree, because interior angles and the adjacent exterior angle will have a sum of 180 degree. So if we have to find the exterior angle, we will do 180 minus 144, which will be 36 degree. Now number of exterior angles, how we can find out? By dividing, because the total measure of the exterior angle is 360 degree. So number of exterior angles, how we can form? 360 degree by n, that is 360 by 36 degree, that is 10 sides. So the polygon will have has 10 sides. Now, if we are asked the interior angle is 160 degree, then each exterior angle is 180 minus 160 degree, which is 20 degree. Now, total measure of the exterior angle is 360 degree. So, the number of exterior angle will be 360 degree by n, which is 20. So, 18. We'll get 18. So, polygon will have 18 sides. Okay. Hopefully, you have understood it. Now, let's move to the next question. 10th question is, in a quadrilateral ABCD, angle A is 40 degree, angle B is 60 degree, angle C is 60 degree. Find the measure of angle D. Is this a quadrilateral convex or a concave? So first we have to make a quadrilateral. Let's make a quadrilateral like this. A, B, C and D. So measure of for A is 40 degree, B is 60 degree and C is 60 degree. And we have to find the value of angle D. So we, as we all know, that sum of the measures of all the interior angles is equal to of polygon is equal to what? 360 degree. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degree, and angle A is 40 degree plus 60 degree plus 60 degree plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. We will move these values to on the other side of the equation. So angle D will be 40 plus 60, 100 plus 160. Okay. So 360 degree minus 160 degree. So angle D will be what? 200 degree. Okay. Angle D will be 200 degree. This quadrilateral is a concave quadrilateral because if it would be a convex quadrilateral, the sum of the measures of the interior angles would be less than 180 degree. But here it is more than 180 degree. So this is a concave quadrilateral. Now let's move to the next question. Now the last one is, how many sides has a polygon if the exterior angle of a polygon is 1/3 of the interior angle? If the exterior angle is 1/3 of the interior angle. So as we all know, the sum of the exterior angles and its adjacent interior angle is equal to what? 180 degree. Okay. So E, that is exterior angle, plus I, that is interior angle, is equal to 180 degree. Okay. This is our first equation. Then in the equation, then the question is said that if the exterior angle of the polygon is 1/3 of the interior angle. So if the exterior angle of the polygon is 1/3 of the interior angle. So IE is equal to 1 by 3. So I is equal to 3E. Okay. So this is our second equation. Now what we will do? We'll put the value of I in the first equation. So E plus 3E is equal to 180 degree. So 4E is equal to 180 degree. So E will be equal to 180 degree by 4. And what you will get? We will get the answer E as 45 degree. Okay, exterior angle we got as 45 degree. So number of exterior angle, this is the measure of exterior angle. So number of exterior angle, how we can find? Is equal to 360 degree upon 45 degree, which is equal to 8. So hence the number of sides in the so hence the number of sides of the polygon will be is equal to 8. Okay, octagon. Hopefully you have understood all the questions from the exercise. We will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care. Goodbye and thank you.